everyone, this is Jyotsna Tiwari and welcome to today's daily current affairs session where we will discuss each and every point about current affairs which is important for your upcoming exam. So let's have a look guys, this is Jyotsna Tiwari and let's have a look of today's session. So here you can see the first news of today's session and the news is, first of all let me change my pen color and the news is that Arunachal Pradesh will be provide Arunachal Pradesh will provide 100% tap water connection to all its homes by the 2023. Okay, so Arunachal Pradesh will provide 100% tap water connection to all its home by 2023. What is the Water Life Mission? Okay, so let's have a look at what is the Water Life Mission. Here we can see that the Jal Jeevan Mission is a scheme under the Ministry of Jal Shakti. Okay, so Jal Jeevan Mission is a scheme of under the Ministry of Jal Shakti which aims to provide safe and adequate drinking water to all households in rural India. The purpose of this project is to implement measures like grey water management, water conservation, rain water harvesting, etc. Okay, these are the important points. So what is the traditional mode of water supply in northeastern states? So let's have a look at traditional mode of water supply in the northeastern state. Here we can see that the North Indian states are located in hilly areas. The traditional mode of water supply is completely gravity based. Okay, it's completely gravity based. Under this mission, it was decided to build water treatment plants to prevent health hazard and ensure drinking water supply. Okay, these are the important points. Last one is, what is the gravity based water supply system? So let's have a look, let's have a discuss some important point which is regarded the base water base supply system. Okay, based on water supply system. So here we can see that the gravity based water supply system are used in hilly areas. The force of gravity is used to generate sufficient water flow pressure for distribution in village. Okay, so guys, these are the important points which is important for your upcoming exam. So let's have a look at which type of question will rise in your exam. So here we can see that first question which will definitely rise in your exam, and the question is that Arunachal Pradesh, recently which state government has provided 100% tap water connection to all the its home and to by the 2023, then your answer will be Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, next one is Jal Jeevan Mission. Let's have a talk about Jal Jeevan Mission. Okay, so okay, here we can see that the basically what is the instrument which is covered under this particular mission. So here you have the grey water management, water conservation, rain water harvesting, etc. These are the included in this particular mission. Okay, life mission. So these are the important points which is we have already discussed about it. So let's have a look of next news guys. If you have any question, then you can ask me in the comment box. And here is the second news of today's session, and the news is that the Ministry of Tourism signed an MOU with the TAAI and the FLO to promote tourism as a sustainable livelihood model. Okay, so basically Ministry of Tourism signed an MOU with the whom? With the TAAI and FLO to promote tourism as a sustainable livelihood model. Okay, so the Union Minister of State for Tourism, Mr. Prahlad Singh Patel, signed a formal MOU with the Travel Agents Association of India. This is the abbreviation of TAAI and FICCI is ladies. FICCI Ladies Organization. This is the abbreviation of FLO. FICCI Ladies Organization is the abbreviation of FLO with the Ministry of Tourism. With whom? So Ministry of Tourism. So what is the characteristics of this news? So let's have a look and let's discuss some important point regarding this news. So here we can see that this MOU will provide an opportunity to increase the participants of women in the tourism sector. Okay, the FLO and TAI initiative will emphasize personal and hospitality skills, leading to more option to the less capital. This initiative encouraged travel to at least 15 destinations within the country. This would be a mandate for the membership base of FLO and TAI is more than 8,000 women and their family support system. Basically, in this particular scheme, in this particular model, basically targeted in the, by the women. Okay. It will also conduct community-based tourism activities in each state around the iconic moment of tourism site. Okay, so these are the important points which is important for your exam. Next one is that women will be tour guides, run food stalls, run souvenir stalls, composite accounts and the landmark marks with their arts and craft. Okay, so these are the important. Next one is it will also create awareness about the Incredible India Tourism Facility Certifications Program. Okay, guys. So these are the important points which is regarding this particular news. So which type of question will rise in your exam? So here is first question which will definitely rise in your exam, that recently the Ministry of Tourism signed an MOU with two organization. What is the two organization name? Then your answer will be TAAI and FLO. So what is the abbreviation of TAAI? So your answer will be Travel Agents Association of India. FICCI abbreviation is FLO abbreviation is FICCI Ladies Organization, and which is conducted by Ministry of Tourism. Please remember this. Focused on women's. Okay, there are almost 8,000 women participated in this particular program and support to their family. There are travel destination which is at least 15 destination with the country. This would be mandate to FLO and TAIS. Okay, so I hope you clear each and everything in details. So let's have a look of next session. Okay, so here is the next news of today's session, and the news is USISPF confirmed 2020 leadership award on Anand Mahindra and Shantanu Narayana. Okay, so basically here you can see that USISPF confirmed as 2020 leadership awards. Okay, on Anand Mahindra and the Shantanu Narayana. Anand Mahindra, President of Mahindra Group, and Shantanu Narayan, President and CEO of Adobe, will be awarded the 2020 Leadership Award by the top India-focused business advocacy group in the US for their remarkable ambitions to strengthen the US-India bilateral business partnership. Okay, so these are the important points. What is the main idea behind this? So here we can see that the US-India Strategic Partnership Forum announced that the award will be presented during the third annual leadership summit titled the US-India Week Navigation New Challenge to be held in last week of the August. What is USISPF? So here we can see that the US-India Strategic Partnership Forum is a non-profit organization that aims to strengthen bilateral and strategic partnership between the US and the India through policy advocacy that promotes economic growth, entrepreneurship, job creation, and on-time innovation. So guys, these are the important points regarding this news. So let's have a look at which type of question will rise in your exam regarding this news. So first question which will definitely rise in your exam, and the question is that recently USISPF confirmed the 2020 leadership award on between two persons. So Anand Mahindra and the Shantanu Narayan. So who is the Anand Mahindra? So Anand Mahindra is the president of Mahindra Group. And who is the Shantanu Narayan? So Shantanu Narayan is the president and CEO of Adobe. Okay. So here is the 2020 Leadership Awards to India Focused Business Advocacy. Okay. These are the important points. Okay. Guys, you will have to learn the summit leadership title. So the title of this summit leadership is US-India Week Navigation Navigating New Challenges. Okay, US-India Week Navigating New Challenges. So basically this is the leadership summit title. Okay, it is important for your exam. The next one is that the US-India Strategic Partnership Forum is non-profit organization. That is the basically this is the non-profit organization. So what is the full form of, guys? You will have to learn the abbreviation of USISPF. So abbreviation of is the USISPF is US-India Strategic Partnership Forum is a forum. This is the abbreviation of USISPF. Okay. So, okay, that's all for this. What is the objective behind this particular policy? Then this is the objective of this policy is to promote economic growth, entrepreneurship, job creation, and on-time innovation. These are the important points which is included in this particular program. Okay, so I hope you will understand each and everything in details, guys. If you have any question, then you can ask me in the comment box. Okay, so let's have a look for the next news. And here is the next news on your screen. And the news is Ashwini Bhatia appointed as new managing director of SBI. Okay, please remember that Ashwini Bhatia has appointed as the new managing director. That means new MD of SBI. So what is State Bank of India's about? Let's have a look at Ashwini Bhatia has appointed as the managing director of the State Bank of India by the appointments of the committee of cabinet headed by the Prime Minister of India. He will be appointed in place of P.K. Gupta. That means previously managing director of SBI was P.K. Gupta and now replaced with the Ashwini Bhatia. Okay, he replaced with the Ashwini Bhatia. So what is the main idea behind this particular news? So let's have a look at Mr. Bhatia has been serving as deputy MD and CEO of SBI Mutual Fund. He also served as the chief general manager of SBI and full-time director of SBI Capital Market. Earlier, the Bank Board Bureau has recommended his name of appointed to the post of MD. Okay. So what is the function of the Bank Board Bureau? So let's have a look here. You can see the new name. You listened to that Bank Board Bureau. So let's have a look at what is the Bank Board Bureau. So the Bank Board Bureau BBB is an autonomous body of the Government of India formed in 2016. Aimed at improving the governance of public sector banks, it has the authority to make recommendation for the appointment of full-time directors as well as non-executive presidents of nationalized banks. Okay, so these are the important points which is important for your exam. Some more point which is not shown in this particular news. Okay, but please have a look that what is generally one question which is normally asked in almost every second exam. Okay, and the question is that what is the previous name of State Bank of India? So guys, you will have to learn that previous name of State Bank of India is Imperial Bank. Okay, I hope you have listened about it, but if you didn't, then you can see here. Okay, so previous name of State Bank of India is Imperial Bank. Imperial Bank is formed in 1921, which is renamed with the State Bank of India in 1955. Okay, so let's have a look at which type of question will rise in your exam. So first question which will definitely rise in your exam is that recently SBI appointed as the managing director of whom? Then your answer will be Ashwini Bhatia. Ashwini Bhatia is replaced with, then your answer will be P.K. Gupta. Okay, so these are the important points which is important for your upcoming exams. So RBI established in which act? Sorry, SBI established in which act? So SBI established in the act SBI Act 1955. Previous name of State Bank of India is Imperial Bank, which is established, which was established in 1921, and the current name is State Bank of India, which is nationalized in the 1955. Okay, I hope you will understand each and everything in details. Please remember the abbreviation of BBB. BBB's abbreviation is Bank Board Bureau. Okay, so let's have a look last news of today's session, and the news is that ICICI Lombard merged with the Bharti AXA General Insurance. Okay, so recently ICICI Lombard merged with the Bharti AXA General Insurance. So let's have a look and let's have learned some important key points regarding this news, and the points are that recently ICICI Lombard General Insurance Company is going to merge with the Bharti AXA's non-life insurance business through a scheme. According to the ICICI Lombard, it will be the third largest non-life insurer merger in India. So who are the non-insurance companies? So let's have a look that non-life insurance companies are involved in providing insurance in addition to life insurance. Such insurance includes automobile insurance, health insurance, travel insurance, home insurance, theft insurance, etc. Okay, it provides for payment based on the loss from a particular event. So these are the work basically of non-insurance company. So let's have a look here. You can see the name, that is Airtime. So guys, as well, you all know very well that RBI is regulated all banking sector in India, as well as IRDAI is regulated the insurance sector in India. Okay, so what is the abbreviation of the IRDAI? So here you can see that the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. This is the abbreviation of the IRDAI, which is regulated, which regulated the whole insurance system in the India. The national agency, actually this is why, okay, national agency of the government of India for the insurance industry of India. It is regulatory body established under the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority Act 1999 and reports to the Ministry of Finance. Okay, its headquarters is located in Hyderabad, Telangana. Okay guys, I hope you'll understand each and everything in details. We already discussed each and every point which is important for this exam. Okay, so let's have a look at which type of question will rise in your exam regarding this news. So first question which will definitely rise in your exam, and the question is that recently ICICI Lombard is merged with recently which insurance company? Then your answer will be Bharti AXA General Insurance Company. Okay, so next one is, what is the abbreviation of IRDAI? So Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India is the abbreviation of IRDAI. Okay, what is the establishment of the year IRDAI? So established year of the IRDAI is 1999, headquarter Hyderabad, Telangana. Okay guys, so I hope you'll understand each and everything in details. If you have any doubt, so you can ask me in the comment box. So guys, in your screen you can see the quiz, of the screenshot of the quiz. So basically the behind the purpose of this screenshot, I want to tell you something, that guys, if you want to give the quiz on daily basis, for that you will have to go to the Google Play Store, where you will you can download the entry app now. Register yourself and register your email ID, where you can give the quiz on daily basis and analyze yourself, that where are you stand right now. Okay guys, also you can go to the our YouTube channel, download the you can go to our YouTube channel. Okay, type Banking 2.0, subscribe the channel, and don't forget to tap on the bell icon. So that's all for the today guys. Please download the entry app now and give the quiz on the daily basis. So I hope you'll understand each and everything in details. Thanks for cooperate with me. Don't forget to like, comment, and share this session as much as you can guys. You can share this session with your relative, colleague, friends, whomever you are studying. Also you can share this session on your Telegram group, Facebook group, and the WhatsApp group, wherever in the social media you are available. Okay, so thank you so much for cooperate with me. Have a nice day.